Hi, this is Kimberly. Please enjoy your podcast, but remember our doctors are only here to educate, not diagnose. If you have any questions or need any further information, please email me. My email address is kim@mfwellness.org. Hi everyone, thanks for tuning in. Today we have the pleasure of having Dr. Leapley here with us. She is a chiropractor. And she also specializes in acupuncture, so she's going to be talking to us about that today.
So this is our test podcast, really, in a couple ways. One, will anybody ever come be interviewed by us again? Is the first question we need to answer. And then number two, are we capable of letting someone else talk? Are we, Dr. Fink?
Are we?
Are we? Or like, what do you mean? Because that's such a crazy concept. But no, it's letting someone else have the reins of the answering the questions. No, I want to venture to guess that Dr. Kirsten Leapley may have more knowledge regarding acupuncture, but maybe that won't stop you. I don't know.
Maybe it won't.
It's going to be fun.
Who knows what's going to happen? Who's going to know what's going to happen? So,
I'd like to say I was promised that he would take over the conversation.
Oh, good. Thank God.
Promised or warned?
We lead with that. Yeah. We lead with that. That way people know. So we have had a billion questions over the years about acupuncture. A billion. And just like chiropractic, the last 20 years have been amazing in terms of discovery now that we're down at the neural level. Now that we're really looking at nerves, what happens when you pinch them? What happens when you release them? I've talked about this before, this holier-than-thou Western medicine dichotomy where they're like, well, we don't know if acupuncture works. But really, one out of every five people that has walked on this planet has used acupuncture in one way or another. So I don't really know that Western medicine can really roll up its sleeves and be like, maybe this doesn't work. You know, come on,
yeah,
man.
It's also over yourself. It's also hard to have an argument when there's legitimate studies regarding functional MRI.
Yeah, it's
Dr. Norman Kettner.
Oh my gosh!
And Harvard have been doing functional
MRI. He works at Harvard, literally Harvard, and Dr. Kettner are researching
MRI. I mean, I don't know if you heard of it.
I mean, yeah. Anyway, we're not going to waste time validating whether or not it works. It obviously works. If you have a problem with that, just go download any of the PDFs. Or maybe we'll break dance fight you outside the office or something. I don't want to waste precious time talking.
We've been working on our pop lock and dropping, so.
It's true. We're pretty legit right now. There was a vicious robot going on this morning.
Oh, yeah.
It was over here,
trifecta, yeah.
By this adjusting table. Maury, you should have seen it.
By who?
It was me and Dr. Matt. Mm-hmm. Just absolutely throwing it down. And then, as usual, some patient looking up from the table in absolute horror. As we danced near her.
I've experienced a patient looking up and...
Oh, yeah. they love it.
Dancing.
They're like, what's that soft rustling? And they look up and their doctor is absolutely throwing it down. And there's no music. No appropriate music for it.
I usually wait until the patient can't see, but Peggy can see me doing it.
Absolutely.
And then...
Absolutely.
Now, everybody that is listening to the podcast is going to watch for us to all be breaking it
down. Oh, I know. The making the staff lose their minds is probably my favorite thing to do. You know what I mean? It's probably my favorite thing to do. Okay.
We've already taken away from Dr. Leapley.
Yeah, she was just here for a couple minutes. So, Dr. Leapley, we've been taking care of her for years. She's taken care of us for years. And like I said, acupuncture is something people ask about all the time. And we refer all of our people to her because she's just wonderful. And we took a poll. We got a bunch of questions together.
Yeah. We've whittled the billion down to 11.
Kimberly whittled them down to 11.
And then we have a surprise question that was offered by a patient a couple days ago.
Surprise
question.
Well,
not a surprise, but a really important and really relevant question. So, okay. Yeah.
Nice, dude.
Okay. So Dr. Leapley is going to tell us a little bit about herself and how she got into chiropractic.
Well, my father is actually a chiropractor and does acupuncture. So grew up with all of the weird stuff. I was, the strange kid.
Did you feel railroaded into it?
I did not.
Okay.
But I was adjusting my dolls at, 1 and 2 years old. They all
had
perfect chiropractic alignment.
Yeah, you didn't have a chance.
Yeah.
Perfect.
And I always was jealous of the kids eating the Flintstone vitamins because they looked like candy.
Right.
And I always got these Chinese herbs that were disgusting.
Oh my, literally from China?
Literally from China. And
fantastic.
Crushed into
Yeah. With a mortar and pestle?
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Jealous. Very jealous. But I went to Logan Chiropractic and did my postgraduate acupuncture studies there. And then I've been practicing chiropractic and acupuncture for 11 years.
11 years. You didn't graduate with Dr. Fink, did you?
No.
You're younger than us. You're much younger than us.
Not much.
Your age. Your age.
When you say our age.
Your age. Sassy man. Well,
even younger than him.
Wow. My God.
I know.
Like Kim's age.
You'll never know.
Yeah, I'll never ask. There's a couple things I've learned over the years, Kim.
Yeah.
How long does it take to do acupuncture?
That's a great question.
A treatment, the first treatment's usually longer, of course.
Right.
We do a big history, look at a lot of physical findings that they look at in acupuncture that are kind of different, like your tongue, looking at the shape and color coating.
Do you look at their lymph nodes? Because, man,
not a personal question.
I'm in so much pain.
Yeah, it's just good we're not on video right
God,
now.
God, I know.
What is that thing growing on your neck?
Doc.
It's called an immune response. You know?
Yeah, it's a massive immune response.
There's acupuncture for that.
Man.
These questions we have from the patients, I'll do the first one.
Oh,
so
okay.
So how does acupuncture work?
Oh, my God.
And I guess that's going to be abbreviated.
Say yes. That's a big question. But what I love about acupuncture is it is just completely different than Western medicine. They're looking at the body very holistically, like we do as chiropractors, but a very different way of looking at it. And in acupuncture, they're looking at how the energy, the chi, flows through our body. And there's 12 main meridians that those flow through. And meridians are kind of like a blood vessel or a nerve. They've got a path that they always follow along.
Do they go up and down or left and right or both?
Mostly up and down.
Okay.
Yep. So you have right and left meridians, and most of them correlate with different organs. And in acupuncture, you get a symptom when there's an imbalance in the energy flow in those meridians. And so the acupuncturist's job is to figure out where is that imbalance, what's causing that imbalance, and work on fixing that imbalance.
And you do that by what?
Acupuncture needles are great at moving the energy in our body. There's also things like Chinese herbs that can help.
Are those hard to get?
They are not hard to get anymore.
Really? They're really like, get out of here.
There are some brands that come straight from China.
The herb embargoist?
The herb council?
Sure.
Oh, my gosh. Like the Shadow Council?
But for herbs. Yeah, you know they're like 10 trillion-year-old people sitting around a room deciding where their herbs can go.
Sure.
So there isn't one of those.
Not that I've heard
She's
of.
She's not allowed to say.
Yeah. Good point. All right.
When you do the diagnosis and you take what you're going to do, you do a complete history. And you have them fill out questions regarding, do you feel sluggish in the morning? Do you feel sluggish in the evening? Like those kind of things. So it's more than just like symptoms though, right?
Right. There are a lot of questions and acupuncture looks at so many things with emotion, digestion, sleep, energy, as well as pain. So there's questions about all those things.
We also have a patient who asked, how long does it take for you to feel the effects or to potentially heal after the treatment?
I'd say it's a lot like chiropractic. It depends on how acute or chronic that condition is, how severe it is, chiropractic.
Whether or not you're actively trying to make it worse every single day.
Exactly.
Stop running. Okay. No problem.
Exactly. I tell my patients if they do their homework that I give them, then it will work quickly and last. But, yeah, you can't push that boulder up the hill all day long.
What are some examples of homework?
It depends on what the problem is. Lots of times, digestive issues or anxiety issues. Both will come from eating too much sugar. I know, surprise.
Yeah.
But if that person's going to go and binge on their Ben and Jerry's right after we do acupuncture and every day.
Or like a cake
there's
donut.
Only so much we're going to get.
Yeah.
But if they make an effort to make those changes that are necessary along with the acupuncture and maybe some herbs or other supplements.
Gotcha. You're not just stabbing. You've got a multifaceted approach.
Yeah. So people do feel immediate stress relief, lots of times immediate pain relief.
Mm-hmm.
Here is the next question.
Mm-hmm.
Does it help with arthritis? And if so, how many sessions are usually needed for that?
Again, that'll depend on what kind of arthritis and how mm-hmm. long and how severe. But yes, arthritic conditions usually respond really well to acupuncture, and especially to the herbs. In Chinese medicine, there's a couple different etiologies for mm-hmm. arthritic. Mm-hmm. A lot of theirs are cold or hot-based, or dampness. So there's several different kinds of arthritis in acupuncture, and based on which kind a person has, would be different points in different herbs. And
yeah, it broadly mimics the metabolic versus and the rheumatic arthrosis, and then the gravity and injury-based arthrosis. It's interesting the way that it gets characterized, like different names, but all is going to fall in the same thing. That's pretty cool how that lines up.
So again, how many sessions? I say most people, if they're going to have great results, which most people do, 3 or 4 visits, people usually notice a decent change.
Wow. That's a lot faster than I thought.
And again, depending on how well they do their homework.
Good point. 3 visits here, we don't even know your name yet. You know what I mean?
I don't.
But we know your spine.
Yeah.
But for complete resolution, that would probably be an ongoing thing. But again, it really depends on how much of that's genetic, how much of that's lifestyle. Awesome.
And I think this question from a patient goes along those same lines you were just talking. Do you need to stay regular with visits mm-hmm. to benefit from it?
Most people do benefit from, traditionally, at the change of the seasons is a good time to get an acupuncture.
Oh, really? Huh.
Yeah, because cool our bodies do. They shift from...
Wonderful. So right now.
Exactly, right now.
A lot of sinuses today.
A lot of sinuses today.
Yeah, exactly. And part of that is, it's that change in that energy, and that's why you have spring and fall, all that sinus gunk. Again, if people are eating well, not carrying all of their stress in their shoulders, they probably don't need it all the time. Seasonally would be good. If you're the kind of person who's working the 80-hour weeks and super type A and all stressed out, then more regularly would probably behoove you.
Why are you looking at me, bro?
Is it true that some needles need to stay in the body after the session is over? And if so, why? Oh, that's an awesome one. That's the best. I got the best question.
That's the best question.
So do you walk around? Yeah, somebody walk around with the needles in?
In China, yes.
Really?
If you're walking down the street, I have actually not been to China, but my father and the gentleman that I took acupuncture courses from said that you do see people with acupuncture needles in their head.
Are some
here
of them
there.
Long? Like, what's the longest needle? You got like a 3-footer?
Yeah, my longest one's about 6 inches.
6 inches. And then what's the tiniest one?
Oh, they're little, like, quarter-inch, half-inch.
So there's more than one question from the patients that are asking about certain conditions. So I'll start with one. Is there an acupuncture treatment for weight loss?
Oh, my gosh.
Yes. There, of course, are so many reasons for weight gain that you have to get to the bottom of what's the cause.
Yeah,
but a lot of times people have addiction issues, and acupuncture is great for that.
Do you put the needle in their tongue so they can't close their mouth?
That's a really awful idea.
It'll stop them.
Never done
that. That's great. I was like, gonna like.
When are you gonna take this up?
Put it through the top and bottom lip.
We're not.
Just pierce them.
Top and bottom lip.
If it's anxiety based or anything like that, treating the underlying condition.
You have
most weight gain is
absolutely
a side effect for.
That's why I like that you have such a comprehensive intake form and the time you spend with the patients. It's like hours. Like, unfortunately, some people still don't go to the chiropractor first. By the time they get here, they've been to a couple of doctors. Everybody's failed them. And they get here, they're like, oh, you guys are miracle workers. But we always tell them, well, if you'd come here first, we wouldn't seem so great.
Right.
But man, I bet, you know, these people that maybe have failed traditional methods or even alternative methods, complementary methods, show up in your office. Man, I bet there's never a straight case. Like, just like, oh, it's straight up this. No problem. Easy. I saw you and you walked in the door. You know?
Right. Yeah, those
That's
people
wild,
are already.
Because you've got to be an even higher tier at diagnosing. So I enjoy your intake form. Have you seen her intake form, Dr. Fink?
Yes, when I was filling it out.
It's fantastic.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
When is acupuncture not a good idea?
Oh, wow. Good one.
I actually couldn't come up with an answer for that. I think it's always a good idea.
Awesome. So there's no contraindications per se.
So you can get it while you're pregnant.
Yes, it's wonderful during pregnancy. I had acupuncture to help. My number three was a week overdue. So we did some acupuncture to get labor going. But it was amazing how immediate those contractions ramped up.
Absolutely.
When we put in the acupuncture needles. So, yeah, fertility usually
nice one.
Responds well to acupuncture. A lot of herbs, too, and of course, just getting to the bottom underlying stress.
And since you said you couldn't think of a time when it's not a good idea, I'm guessing the question, can you do it on children, might be a yes.
It is. Mm. I love doing acupuncture on children. My children love getting acupuncture. It sounds so weird. But they'll be like, oh, I hurt, or oh, I don't feel good. And they'll come up and be like,
yeah, having access to that. Like, my kids chase me around the house. Like, I got this, I got that, I got this. I can imagine having access to somebody that just makes it go away. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Like that. I was snapping because I got that fan.
Well, the thing about that snap, that was clean, crisp, concise.
She's probably got like a little pocket holster of needles. And she's like,
I think she brought it.
I have a canister of needles. I do.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, so we can. We can acupuncture.
I don't want to ruin her needles like with the my six inch foulness. Yeah, nice.
You don't keep the needles. You use it once, you throw it away.
Oh, really? You don't put them in alcohol or something?
No, it's a biohazard. Once it enters your flesh, it has to be thrown away.
Especially.
I suppose you could autoclave them, but I don't. I have disposable needles.
In my dreams, I've got an autoclave. Kim, do you know what an autoclave is?
No.
Since you laughed?
No, but no.
Kim, the way. In the laboratory, we need sterile instruments and sterile containers. And heat alone is not enough, Kimberly.
It's not
enough.
We
need to take that heat and we need to drive it into the material as deep as we can.
You gotta drive it, Kim.
So how do we do that? We heat it up and then we increase the air pressure inside the thing. So hot that it would crack your skull.
Right open.
Do you have one of those?
Yeah, because it's for perfect sterility. Because I want to control my environment. Where'd this cup come from? Which is, because I have four sons, you'd think that I would have loosened up by now. But actually, I'm even worse in terms of sterility.
Hmm. Yeah, I mean, you can tell by how this office is run, how clean we are. And the fact that everyone that comes is like, oh my gosh, you guys are still open? You guys have been open the entire time?
Yeah. Oh,
yes.
Look at that.
Yes, we have.
It's like we have some kind of method for monitoring and ensuring that this is going to be a safe office visit for everybody.
Accurate.
Rather than just tossing caution to the wind, being like, we had to close down. Or, you know, they told us to. You know, like they actually said the opposite. But that's a super long story. I won't be able to stop myself if we.
Do patients get adjusted before or after acupuncture?
Good one, Dr. Fink.
100% depends on what they like. Some people prefer it one way or the other.
Okay, so it's not a thing.
Sometimes it's just what fits better in my schedule.
What's the tell us the craziest case you've seen? What's the wildest thing you've seen? I mean, like a limb regrow, you know, or somebody get pregnant, immediately
walk again.
We've had that here.
Yeah.
Moving stuff with their mind.
Yes. They become telekinetic and it's pretty amazing. Oh,
sign me up.
I can't think of anything incredibly cool
off the
top of my head, but I think it's incredibly cool how quickly people do respond.
Yeah.
Like, anxiety, insomnia, things like that, that have been torturing them for months, years,
et cetera.
I bet
you get people in there and you put the needles in and 3 minutes later they're dead asleep and that they haven't slept like that in years.
Exactly.
It's got to feel good.
It is.
It's pretty cool, man.
What's your favorite thing to treat? Like, do
you
have a favorite
That's what I was trying to ask.
Oh.
Hmm.
Good job, Kim.
I don't have a favorite.
No.
You don't have a favorite?
Favorite thing to treat?
Yeah.
For acupuncture?
Sure.
No, I like it all.
Like if two people came in and one person had this and one person had that, you'd be like, you get out of here. You person, come in, I'll treat you.
It would depend on which one seems like they were going to be the one that does their homework.
Oh my gosh. Nice.
Oh, selective.
Nice.
Okay. That's what real doctors do. Do you guys have your favorite thing you treat?
This isn't about us, Kim.
Just real quick.
Yeah,
just real
quick. I'll just go ahead and talk about myself, Kim.
Just,
I've been trying to be cool the whole time.
One word answer.
Kim just opens
the
box.
And then gives us a one word answer. And then tells us, just answer in one word. Yeah,
yes.
Kim, we're going to do that.
Yes.
Okay, yeah. Yes is the answer for me, too.
That's another podcast.
Dr. Josh would be children. That's the
specifically?
Nope, just children.
So it's yours, Dr. Mom.
Probably athletes.
Yep.
I like the motivation they have to get better or to improve their performance.
Nice, dude. Dr. Matt?
Bakers. No. Bakers. Anyone that bakes.
If you make food, if you produce food, Dr. Fink wants to see you. We've had an incredible run of dough in this office the last 2 weeks. I've never in my life been pampered, is the word,
by
our patients. And it's not even the holidays. Usually the holidays we get
destroyed. Gardeners are good too. Especially this time of year, gardeners, they bring all your tomatoes.
Looks like she does have a favorite.
Sure. I brought in some, did you get any of the sunflower seeds I brought in? I made some sunflower seeds. The boys and I did.
They're fantastic.
Thank you very much, Dr. Fink.
You're welcome.
Okay.
So I do love seeing children, and I did want to say one more thing.
Hit me.
So we talked about when is acupuncture not a good idea, right. And of course, there's the people with the fear of needles.
Yeah.
But I say that they can still get acupuncture because I also have a laser.
A class 4 therapy laser?
No, just a little laser. Cold laser.
Okay. I'm sorry.
So instead of the needle, somebody can get a laser acupuncture treatment?
Yeah.
Yes. And actually, there's tons of research about the lasers. There's actually probably more research with the lasers than the needles.
Are you talking about acupressure now? Am I doing that right?
No, she's talking about an acu-laser.
Acu-laser. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. I mean, it's still acupuncture. Acupressure points are the same points. But some of the research, the laser is maybe not quite as effective, but like 90% of as effective as
a
needle.
And if it's going to stop them from doing it, then it's like 190% more effective. You know?
Precisely.
If it wasn't going to happen with a needle, then.
But even people who are terrified of needles and having blood draws and that kind of thing, when I show them how tiny an acupuncture needle is, you can fit like 50 of my needles in a hypodermic needle.
Wow.
They are...
I want to see these.
Kim is now blown
very
away.
Very small.
Did you guys on the podcast, that sound you just heard, that's Kim's jaw hitting the ground.
She wasn't real interested. Yeah. And now...
Did you see that? Kim cares.
Like, I don't like needles, and that's intriguing to me.
So now... We can,
that's great, Kim. Good
but
for
yeah.
You.
So people who are terrified of needles, once I put in that first acupuncture needle, they're usually like, "You did it? Yeah."
Do you ever do the thing where you distract them and just stab them? Be like, "Look, it's already in." They're like, "Oh my gosh!" You're like, "Might as well go forward now because I got you with one."
I think that
probably
happens.
Don't do the things I say.
I talk and but they really don't. They're like, "Are you going to start yet?" I'm like, "You've got 5 in. What are you talking about?"
Oh my gosh.
So people with anxiety about needles really do. Most of them do well with needles, but if they're truly terrified, there's also another option with the laser.
Yeah,
and it's super it's really
cool.
good for kids.
And we try
too.
To explain to people like an acupuncture needle, even though it's called a needle, it's not a needle. It really isn't because it's used as a device to open and close chi, and it's totally different than an actual needle. Okay, so
I would want the needle.
Of course you would.
I'm just saying, I would want to know that there's something lodged in
Listen, I think you've been needled enough in your life that we don't need to be sewing up or needling you anymore.
It's true. I have had many stitches.
Okay. Here's the last question before we start live treatment. Okay. Semi-permanent points and regarding motion sickness. That's not on there. That's the surprise question.
Bonus. Nice. Nice.
So one of our patients was experiencing some motion sickness as they were... traveling the back ways through 94. If you don't know what 94 is, that's a highway out here in
that's known for its rapid and unscheduled changes in elevation.
Yeah. So they were wondering if and then they asked, you know, how would they even treat that? And then I kind of talked to them about the semi-permanent little metallic beads that cover the acupuncture point. So just maybe a couple minutes of explanation of what would go into that.
Well, there are several options. There are like the actual piercings that people get for like migraines that you've probably seen like in their ears. But yes, I've got, they're basically look like little BBs on kind of the back of a Band-Aid. And you can put those on any acupuncture point on the body, or you can put them on auricular points on the ear. And they do. They just sit there and stimulate that point consistently versus... you know, a needle being in there for 15 minutes and then coming out. For nausea and motion sickness in general, there's a point called pericardium 6 on the wrist.
Ooh.
And if you've heard of C-bands, that's what they're doing, is they're stimulating pericardium 6 on the wrist. So that's what people use like on cruises and stuff when they get motion sickness. But pregnant women, chemotherapy patients can all benefit from that.
Okay.
Wow. Wonderful.
Wonderful.
So now we're going to do a little bit of acupuncture on Dr. Josh. Well, not us. Dr. Kirsten Leapley.
Yeah. You guys are probably just trying to stand around and
I'll just give you the needles.
Make faces at me. All right. Where do you want me to just sit here?
But yeah, so as Dr. Kirsten Leapley makes her way over to start the acupuncture. So she's licensed to do this.
I'm going to be quiet the whole time.
It is Dr. Josh's permission that she is done.
To make comments.
So I think it would be easier if you would lie down. And can you take off your socks and shoes?
Yes.
So for right now, I am just cleaning off some acupuncture points with an alcohol swab. I'm doing points that involve the lymphatic system. This lymph node is along the stomach meridian, so we are doing points, and it's very hot, and so we're doing points to drain heat and to improve lymphatic flow.
Cool.
I've done some points on the stomach meridian, spleen meridian, liver, large intestine. I'm getting some weird faces.
Oh, is that what you're dancing about?
Oh, man. It doesn't hurt.
And Dr. Leapley, what do you do when you turn the needle?
You're looking to
find the sweet spot?
Exactly. The energy isn't right at the very top. It's actually a little deeper, and you're looking to find what they call the do chi. But it's that sweet spot where you are really actually releasing that energy in that meridian.
You're looking for, like, resistance?
It's actually more of a release.
Okay.
Like, you're putting it in there, and then you feel, like, more of a release.
You ever like hook all the needles onto a string and pull them on all at once?
Well, I do also have electric that I can connect to the needles and do a little bit of a current, and I accidentally pull them all out fairly often. at the end of the treatment.
Yeah.
You know.
What's one of the most important things regarding acupuncture needles and the recovery of the same amount that you put in should be the same amount that you take out?
Well, I guess that would go with the retained needles earlier, and I think that's usually when my patients retain them, is when I forget the one on the top of their head. But
she's joking, of course.
We usually find it before they leave the office.
Sure, absolutely.
Are any of the gigantic needles in, or these are all the little ones?
Oh, these are the tiniest ones. Shoot.
What do you use the big ones on?
You can do what they call threading it, so you can thread it through several points.
Mm.
You know, if you had a carpal tunnel thing, I could go on that side, but
I gotcha.
You know, down the medial nerve through several points. So I also used the laser on some auricular points on Dr. Josh. The whole body is represented on the ear. Actually, in acupuncture, the whole body is represented on the hand, the face, the ear, the stomach, the foot. You have like foot reflexology, of course. So we did some acupuncture points on the ear for pain. Again, lymphatics, throat in general, a couple balancing points that just help that, again, energy get balanced whatever way it needs to.
And now it's not just Dr. Josh getting acupuncture. It's Andrea. Everybody. And myself are all getting acupuncture.
There's needles flying around.
Alrighty, you are free.
Oof. Thanks, friend. I do feel relaxed.
Okay, so we will leave you guys. 50% of our staff has needles in them. And the experience, if you've never had it done, is actually really pleasant and really relaxing. If you're super type A and you can't seem to settle down, I would highly recommend it because it works really, really well. So for Dr. Leapley, for Kim, for Soundmaster Sarah, for Dr. Matt, for Dr. Maurer, for myself, for Andrea, and for our mom, Judy Rose, thank you all for listening, and we will talk to you guys in 2 weeks.
And a big thank you goes out to Hug Monster Sound for somehow allowing the doctors' voices to sound even better than they already do.